we've seen our first guest in such movies as Harvest Moon and Royal New Year's Eve. Her latest, Road to Christmas, premieres this Sunday night at 8, 7 Central right here on Hallmark Channel. Welcome back, our good friend, Jesse Schram. Yeah, welcome, Jesse. Good to see you. You look very Christmassy in red. We
thank
love that.
You.
Don't let
thank
that.
You.
All things
perfect.
Christmas here, of course.
Countdown to Christmas, I'm ready.
There you go, you are ready. I love
ready?
It. That's right. That's exactly right. Now, in this film, you,
yes.
like most people here on the set, everybody here on the set,
right.
love the holidays. But your character, your Road to Christmas character, Maggie,
yes.
has to work on Christmas in this
bummer.
Film. And she's not even that bummed about it. So what's up with that?
No, well, Maggie is a producer of a very Martha Stewart type show.
Okay.
So they do a Christmas show every year, and it's very special to her. And she's all about making it live, something new, creating something, sharing it with the masses.
I see, okay.
The network is not so sure about that. So they bring in Julia Weiss's son, who wants to produce the show as well, and he's all about tradition, keeping things very much what they have done, what worked, why change it. If it's not broken, don't fix it. So we butt heads the whole way.
Boy.
And she's actually fine with missing Christmas only because the show meant so much to her at one point when she wasn't able to make it home.
Right.
Therefore, the show was her family, and now she's excited to bring it to everyone.
Oh, well, that makes sense.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah,
well, her son is played by Chad Michael Murray.
Yes.
We love him as well. And we have a clip of the two of you attending a Christmas tree lighting party at Julia's home.
Awesome.
Let's take a look.
Here's to the light in each and every one of us. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Aww. How are you doing?
You know, finally decided to shake off my mood. We always have next year to convince your brothers.
Okay, it's okay. This is it's all good. I've got this.
Remind me to order some generators. I mean, if this were this were to happen during the show.
Generators, it is.
Yeah.
No,
all he's got to do is look at you, right?
Well, you say that as part of the script of the movie, but those things happen.
Oh, I know.
No, I mean, that's closer to the truth than I think
we
a lot of people know at home.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, it's very important to have backup. And I know I don't need to tell you this because recently you were part of a performance.
Oh, yes.
And you just barely dodged a major crisis.
Yes. Well, I was asked to sing at a charity event for neurofibromatosis. And that's something that's in Chicago, my hometown. I was super excited, and I get to play live, which is not something I get to do often.
Okay.
I show up, I've got my cat with me, the rental car, like, coming in super late, and the airlines, the guitar didn't show up.
Oh.
The guitar didn't show up, my suitcase didn't show up, so my dress, like everything that was planned to a T.
But you had a cat. You
could I had my cat, which needed to go to the bathroom. I'm like, I just need to get home.
Oh,
so like,
man.
I tried my hardest, you know, keep it together and we'll figure it out. Everything will be okay. So at like 3 a.m. the next day, the morning of the performance,
right.
The guitar comes, the dress comes, and inside I played Cinderella on a show called Once Upon a
right,
Time.
Right, of course.
And inside there was a little note that said, good luck, Cinderella.
Oh.
So it was very, like, everything came together. It was very
and
sweet.
The performance went well?
The performance, well then, of course.
Did the electricity go out?
Wait.
The electricity didn't come out, but I've got my guitar, because that's what I was so concerned about. I've got my dress on. I run out on stage to go sing. I forgot to bring the mic with me. So really,
things happen.
Yeah, take two on the entrance.
Take two.
That's okay.
Two.
I mean, but you're pretty fearless when it comes to obviously performing live,
yes.
as well as other challenges, including rock climbing.
Yeah.
In fact, it was rock climbing, your
so
adventurous
cool.
rock climber, that led you to meet the love of your life. I love this.
Yes. Well, my friend introduced me to rock climbing maybe about a year and a half ago, and so I started. You know, I got harnessed in, started learning, and through that, she also introduced me to my boyfriend, who is a mountaineer and does amazing things in the outdoors.
Look at you guys.
So that's something I never thought, you know, with upper body strength injuries, never thought that I would be climbing. And through her introduction and through him just, you know, saying, give it a shot and taking me to these amazing places outdoors. And
wow.
Yeah, look, I mean, this. I wouldn't do that if I wasn't around people that I trusted 100%.
Oh my gosh. Well, that's, I was going to say, rock climbing is as much about trust as it is about strength. It's I feel like it's more about mind strength than body strength. My husband is a rock climber too, and and then I start to tremble. You know, your arms will shake out.
Oh yeah.
And I just say, just take me down, bring me down, because it's so frightening. Whoa.
I will say I'm almost more scared indoors for some reason. I think because I see the ground and I see the ceiling. And so it's all this mind thing of, I used to be like, oh, it's so much fun, he'd say, it's so much fun. And like, I'd want to fall, and all of a sudden I'd be like, okay. Just breathe. I love you. I love you.
It's so true.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, your love of the outdoors and your fearlessness have really created some interesting situations for you. As a matter of fact, I know that you were staring down some vicious creatures not too long ago when you were out in the wild.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well,
it's like Jesse Schram gone wild.
I love animals, especially outdoors, and I have never seen a bear in person. And we were up in Squamish and up in Whistler.
Beautiful.
And in Canada, that's wildlife is a little bit more readily available and walking around. And my goal on this trip was to see a bear. And so everywhere we'd go, all of a sudden I'd get a text from someone like, you just missed the baby bear. And someone had told me if you go to this mountain biking park up in Whistler, there's a 3% chance that you'll see a bear in the wild.
I love that they gave you like the 3%.
They gave me, and I was like, because I saw an ad, I was like, there's bears and there's people riding by. And they're like, there's 3%. And I was like, we're going. Wow. So we strap in, we get all our equipment on. Never been mountain biking like downhill path before. And sure enough, we get to the top and stop dead in our tracks, and like 10 feet away, there was a mama bear. And of course, you know, you have
to. Yes, right. That's what the first thing I thought of when I saw the three of them, the mama with her babies, you got to be careful.
And then you see these little bears like playing tag and climbing trees. And then one little guy comes over and he stands on his hind legs. And like, I definitely know, you know, don't look them in the eye. I have different precautions, but they were so close, and it wasn't a grizzly, so thank God for that.
Yeah.
But there's just, it was an amazing experience. I literally, for like 10 minutes, just sat and watched them play with each other.
Oh my gosh. Did they know you were there?
They knew that we were there.
And they were okay with, because usually the mama bear, if she has her cubs,
Yeah. But the fact that it wasn't a grizzly also helps for that department.
That's a slight detail there.
Versus
a little bit more used
to humans in there. Or something.
But we were respectful, and you keep a safe distance. But I mean, that's one where I start creeping, and then I'm like, nope, that's a real bear.
Adventurous you are, though.
That's a real bear.
I mean, I got to be hanging out with you more often on the weekend. That's pretty awesome.
Jesse.
Well, thanks for being here. Congratulations.
Yeah, so
looking so forward to this weekend, everybody. Don't miss the Sunday night's premiere of Road to Christmas at 8, 7 Central, right here on Hallmark Channel, where you can see this very talented young lady
Fearless talented lady.